In the heart of Rome, an ancient structure stands as a testament to the grandeur and ingenuity of the Roman Empire. Known as the Colosseum, this magnificent amphitheater bears witness to the architectural and engineering prowess of its builders. Today, we delve into the story of its construction, exploring the design elements and techniques that made it possible for the Colosseum to hold over 50,000 spectators. The Colosseum, or Flavian Amphitheater, was commissioned by Emperor Vespasian in 70 CE as a gift to the Roman people. Construction began under his rule and was completed under his successor, Titus, in 80 CE. This grand structure was built on the site of a lake that had been part of Nero's sprawling Golden Palace. It was a statement of both power and humility, a gift that returned land to the people that Nero had taken for his personal indulgence. The amphitheater's design was a marvel of Roman engineering. The oval-shaped structure measured 615 feet in length and 510 feet in width, with an outer wall reaching a height of 157 feet. The building consisted of four levels, each adorned with distinct architectural elements. The first three levels featured a series of arches framed by half columns, while the fourth level was characterized by a solid wall with small square windows. The construction of the Colosseum relied heavily on concrete, a revolutionary Roman building material made from a mixture of volcanic ash, lime, and water. This concrete allowed the Romans to create large, unsupported spans and complex shapes, which were essential to the Colosseum's design. The amphitheater's signature feature, the vaulted arch, was made possible by the use of this material. The interior of the Colosseum was designed to accommodate a vast number of spectators, with seating organized into three tiers. The lowest tier, reserved for the most important citizens, featured marble seats and offered the best views of the action. The second and third tiers were reserved for the general public, with wooden benches providing seating. Each tier was separated by a wide, sloping corridor, which allowed for efficient crowd movement and easy access to the numerous entrances and exits. Beneath the arena floor lay the hypogeum, a subterranean network of tunnels and chambers. This hidden world served as the backstage for the spectacles held in the Colosseum. Gladiators, wild animals, and stage sets were all housed and prepared in the hypogeum, and a complex system of lifts and pulleys was used to raise them up to the arena floor. The Colosseum's construction was a feat of engineering and a testament to the skills of the ancient Romans. It was a symbol of power and technological prowess, an enduring monument to a civilization that has long since vanished. Today, as we walk among its ruins, we are reminded of the ingenuity and ambition that brought this extraordinary structure to life. And as always, remember to like, subscribe, and comment below on what topic you would like to see in our next video. Until then, take care and stay curious.